Welcome back to my let's play of Mountain Blade Warband. Which last time I was up, well, go over the map, I was over in this area fighting bandits. I've been wandering around looking for something else to do. And in the meantime, that lot have taken over that city. The Rodoks have taken over that city. Suno's already been taken over by the Nords. The Rodoks have already taken that one. So the side I'm allied with, the lot in orange, the Swardians, have lost all their cities. So I'm not going to renew my contract because they're basically losers. Additionally, I thought I'd come over here, look for some forest bandits to fight. And apparently, with the updated version of this mod, you don't get a choice now whether or not there is a bandit hero who gets all the other bandit group to come and join him and follow him around. It happens automatically, which I usually selected it anyway. But I can't take on that many forest bandits by myself, so I've got to try.
We can do this the easy way or the hard way.
And either separate them or... In this case, I was lucky I've got someone who joined on my side. But I've now got a slightly bigger battle of 118 troops against their 92. Which would make this more of a challenge for me. And if my ally wants to go on ahead, I'm more than happy to let him. Because that's a hill. And charging up a hill is a mistake when you're taking on people who are firing arrows at you all the time. So I'll let them come to us and let him charge in first. Take the casualties. At this point, I'll tell my boys to charge. Oh. It would help if I could hit somebody. Apparently that's not going to happen. Okay. I got badly hurt and knocked out of the fight. See if my troops can do what is necessary. It's not looking that good at this point. Kind of hoping that the reinforcements that just arrived can do what is necessary. But I think I'm going to come out of this with a lot less troops than I went into it with. Even with the allies that I had and the fact that I did outnumber them slightly. Yeah, there's a... definitely losing a few people here, as is my ally, as he's got a load of people who are archers who are just... I swing it round. Stood back here firing arrows. Which is not helping my... helping the frontline troops very much. While it's a nice tactic, in theory, does actually require you to actually kill people with those archers. Whereas the battle seems to be going this general direction. Oh, and some more reinforcements. Yes, the joy of climbing up a hill to to get to the fight when you're facing archers is not good. Looks like victory's going to happen anyway, but climbing up a hill while facing archers is bad. I ended up with, what, 13 dead, 38 wounded. He ended up with 17 dead, 13 wounded. And we killed most of them. Although I personally didn't kill anybody. On the nice side, they did actually have some prisoners who now become part of my people. Or at least some of them do. I don't want these guys, mainly because we're at war with them anyway. So they have a lack of morale if they join my side. Right, so having gone out of that, well, there's some nice English longswords and a few bits and pieces that might be useful. But I'll let my companions pick them all up, and at least I went up a level. But now I have a total of 22 troops on my side. Enemies all over the place, I'm running away. And of course, naturally, I've got to find a safe haven when all the towns in the area belong to the enemy. So I'm going to head to the desert part of the map, which I haven't been in during this playthrough, and sit over there and rest up. And while I'm heading this general direction, I noticed that I went up a level, so I will do that. I'll give myself weapon mastery. Not that it really matters that much at this point. And I don't want to fight them. Run away. There's 37 or whatever they are. And whilst I might be able to come out of it okay, I probably wouldn't. I am definitely not renewing my contract. With the losers that I'm currently associated with, because no one likes to be associated with losers. Even me. And yeah, there's a few companions that will be upgraded, or will level up. That's truth. Okay, I've now got 42 people who are actually technically alive. Like I say, in the previous versions of this mod, that was a choice as whether or not you had Bandit Heroes. Now apparently it's going to happen no matter what, which I'm fine with, because I normally selected it anyway. It makes more fun for when you've got a more experienced group of soldiers on your side taking on more and more bandits. Yes. I'm not interested in his story. I am interested in this going in here. Let's go to the tavern to start with, see if there's anybody around in here that's worth talking to. Well, the ransom broker, so I can get a little more cash. About 5,000. I could buy some nicer armor. Or I could buy a war horse or two, but at this point I'm still not really using war horses. I've got enough grain and bread to keep me going. Take a quick walk around the streets. That's a merchant and a weaponsmith. I'm trying to remember where the guildmaster is on this one. Still a nicely done city, these. Ah, okay, he's around this corner. Memory serves me correctly. I do like the way they've managed to put these cities together and the different styles they use depending where on the map you were. That's the guildmaster. I don't mean to say anything to the man. I just wanted to put him on the menu. Well, there's no companions here. There's nothing of particular interest there, so I will go explore some more of the desert. Okay, those two have gone to war. I don't think I want to take on those deserters. Mainly because all my companions need some time to rest up and heal. So even with Jeremus, who is the medic of the group, and at this level he's a pretty good medic for the group, doing whatever he does, it's still not enough to heal them fast, or tremendously fast. The slave driver. You two upgraded to slightly better than useless. Not much better than useless, but slightly. We'll visit the tavern in this one. Ransom broker. No potential companions. I don't know if I've got all the companions or not yet. I'll take a quick walk around the streets in this one, if I can remember where the guildmaster is in this one. I also like the fact they made all these cities, all these towns, slightly different layouts. So that you get a different view, and when you siege them, which I will at some point, well, I will with a load of them at some point, then the troops have different starting places and you have to do different things to, or to go to different places to beat them. There was nothing of particular interest in there. Now I know there's another, there's another town over here and there's one down there somewhere. However, normally the desert bandits are in this kind of area. And as it appears the heroes have started appearing, I imagine there's quite a few desert bandits. And I'm not in any fit condition to take them on. Problem is that I'm a mercenary... they've taken Halma. I'm a mercenary and I'm fighting this lot in pinkish-purple. The lot in green, which are the ones that are in all the areas near me. However, as they've taken Halma, that would be a safe place to rest. There were some desert bandits. Yes, you ran away from a town near here, or a village near here. I don't care. You're just a companion. Okay, I am slightly faster than them, but not by much. If I can catch them. Eek. Okay, I don't want to go to Helmer anymore because it's about to go under siege. By everybody and his brother, by the looks of it. Can I get through this gap? Yeah, I should be able to run fast enough to avoid being chased by them. Struth. Yes. When you're this weak, there's a lot of running away. It still is a very nice map to run away on, but it's probably not that interesting to watch someone navigate the map. As my troops slowly heal, get better, and avoid fighting after that last fight. At least we're almost healed. And there's a town coming up where I can actually I would say rest in, but I'm not really planning on resting as such. But like that, they've got 78 over there, and the level of them, they've got, you know, infantry level 6, archer level 6, archer infantry level 5, archers level 5 and 4. Whereas my guys are at the best level 4. So there's more of them and they're better than I am. Hence the reason I run away a lot at this stage. Look in the tavern, we've got a book merchant. Well, I would buy books from, but I don't have enough money. Well, I could get a couple of books, but not enough to. Black Warbow, I don't have the power to wield that. I do have the power to wield that, but it's kind of six or one, half a dozen the other. Oh, we don't want that knife. So I'll sell that while I'm here. Armor. That's the type of armor I tend to go for the medium stages, because it's relatively cost effective. Unfortunately, I can't afford it yet. Horse merchant. No lame war horses lying around. Which reminds me. Okay, that one's war horses now. Well, that horse is fit. And that horse is fit. Okay, I'm back to my normal horse. And goods, I do need some more foods of different types, so that'll do. We'll buy the grain and the bread while we're here, just because I kind of need more food. And there's a fair bit of stuff in my companion's inventory that I don't need. So I might as well make some of the money back I just spent on food. I'll do that again. Yeah, we're keeping that. We're keeping the top six things, as they might still be useful to some of my people. Equally, I would go raid another town to make some more money. However, that hasn't been too successful the last couple of times I've attempted it, so I will head off towards the direction of the Tundra Bandit camp. I'm hoping either peace breaks out or my mercenary contract expires soon. That way I'll go back to the Step Bandits and start taking a load of Step Bandits. Until then, I will see if I can get some Tundra Bandits to kill, as I know where their camp is. Yes, and because Praven has been taken over, my dye works is not making me any money either. I am still making a profit, thanks to my mercenary payment. Are you a traveller? I tend to check chat taverns when I go past places on the principle that there may be a farmer in there saying his village needs help. Just like I tend to take to check these type places, just in case there's anything that I want to pick up by way of armor, arms, or horses. Some more soldiers ready to upgrade. Oh, manhunters into slave drivers. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4 companions who can level up at some point. But yes, once you've got a base of your own, this game is a lot easier to build up troops and attack things. At the moment I don't have a base of my own, so I've kind of got to pick and choose my fights. So things like 35 Tundra Bandits are a reasonable thing to pick on. Whereas 74 road ops is a thing to run away from. And these are a lot of them, this lot seem to have horses. So, as seems to be my current methodology, I will let my people take care of the people on horseback, and I will avoid them and charge the people on foot. Especially now I've got a big two-handed sword, which has the capability of really hurting people. Assuming I actually hit them. Which is a big assumption, admittedly. Seem to work. Ah, 31 killed, 4 wounded, and I killed 6. Always nice. That's going to do it for this episode. In between times I'll do the upgrades and sell the unwanted stuff and sort out my inventory and stuff like that. But my party can now be 65 big. So looters, who cares about looters? They're not worth the time it takes to run them down. But hopefully I will find a target for the next episode. I hope you enjoyed or found it interesting or enjoyed the pretty pictures of the map as I walked across it and I ran away from things, and hopefully I'll see you down the road.